Welcome back to News Geelong. Hope you're feeling nice and warm. Local bed and breakfast venues, fairs and festivals have urged the state government to rethink new licensing laws which would impact on the continuing growth of these important Geelong and surrounding district services. Geelong Otway Tourism has led the way in seeing changes occur, as Merrill Friend reports.
I'm here at the Geelong Otway Tourism office in Brougham Street, and I was able to talk to Executive Director Roger Grant about the latest liquor licensing laws for the bed and breakfast industry in Geelong.
Yeah, we're very pleased about it. There was a lot of unintentional consequences of the recent changes to the liquor licensing, and one of those was that it really meant it very difficult, if not impossible, for our local small operators, those that run bed and breakfast, to actually present local wine and have their clients enjoy local wine. And the government have realised the mistake that was made, the unintended capture of those people in the licensing reform, and they've exempt them from it. So it means that now locals can present our local wine, our fabulous wine, to visitors, and that's terrific.
So earlier in the year we were discussing there have been lots of other industries in the Geelong region that have been affected by this as well, one of which were the Geelong wine growers and the wineries. They've been told that if they had music they would have this increased penalty. What's happening with that one?
We've still got some challenges to go. It's not all over yet as far as those particular businesses are concerned. They are caught up still as a major venue and are subject to the same licensing provisions as the clubs and pubs. Now, again, I believe that in all honesty, that wasn't intended originally. We've made a first step with the changes to the accommodation providers, and we hope that this will be the first of several steps to come. We've worked hard both at Geelong Otway Tourism and in our partners with Tourism Alliance to make the government realise that there had to be changes. We're appreciative that they've listened to us and made those changes, but as I said, we hope there's more to come.
Here at Geelong Otway Tourism, Merrill Friend, News Geelong.
Thank you, Merrill Friend. The Professional Golfers Association Australia has launched a new golf tournament to be played at the Torquay Sands Golf Club. The event is a full PGA Tour of Australasia Order of Merit stroke play event and will include two cut-offs, a first for the PGA Tour of Australasia, as Ian Nichols reports.
This is the Sands at Torquay, a fantastic resort layout, and very soon it's going to be the scene of a new PGA knockout tournament. All the golf stars will be here in the third week of January, and it's something of an experiment. It's certainly something that's going to give golf a huge boost. We're talking today with Darryl Brown, who's the pro here at the Sands Torquay.
Yes, Ian, myself and all the members here have got a really good vibe around the place at the moment.
And you'll be obviously very integrated into the, you know, the development of this tournament, which is still a little way away. And then when it arrives, I guess you're right into it.
Yes, we've had the tournament itself has been developing over the last few years, the shortened format. That's a little different in pro golf, and we're currently having quite a number of meetings about getting organised for the event next January.
Well, it has created a lot of attention. This is a brand new format, and it's quite radical. Would this be golf's answer to 2020, if you like, cricket?
It's certainly being touted as that amongst the media, but a number of places across the world have spoken about it, but it's certainly the first time in the world that the pros have played this shortened format.
Perhaps you could just quickly outline the 3 or 4 days, what happens in the course of this one, the knockout as you're calling it.
Yes, certainly, Ian. The first 2 days, there's 130 odd players that play the first couple of days. Then the field gets cut to the leading 50 players plus ties. Those guys play another stroke round again on Saturday to cut to the leading 32. And then on the Sunday, they play 6-hole matches, just in that normal knockout format where the number one qualifier plays 32nd and so on down until we get a winner.
Well, the cream certainly rises to the top here. You can't have a bad day or even a bad hole, can you?
No, I think the thing that everybody's looking forward to under that shortened format is, you know, we'll see some really attacking golf, and our course here lends itself to taking a number of risks, so it should be really good viewing.
Yes, for those people who are viewing right across the metro area of Melbourne may not be familiar with the Sands, it's a very new layout, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Yeah, we're in just about to begin our 7th year, so we're 6 years old in July.
Yeah, it's a fan. You'd call it like a links course?
Yeah, we don't have much trees. We sort of describe the course as a resort links course. We have the first nines basically covered by a fair bit of residential stuff, and then our back nines a little bit more out in the native stuff.
At the Sands at Torquay, this is Ian Nichols for News Geelong.
Thank you, Ian, and we'll keep you posted on developments in that big golf tournament. The announcement of a $25 million state government grant for the third stage development at Cadinia Park was announced yesterday as another set of significant community features that will involve many elements of our Geelong community. Nathan Curry reports.
First of all, are you able to point out where all the new redevelopments of Skilled Stadium?
There's no doubt that from this stand here right around to the other stand, that's stage three of the redevelopment. If we're fortunate enough to get the World Cup, if you look back this way, that'll be redeveloped as well. But the $25 million that's been announced by the state government, by the Premier, Mr. John Brumby, he's come down to Geelong this morning and announced a $25 million funding for Cadinia Park stage three redevelopment. So that's great.
Will that funding cover the whole redevelopment, or is there more funding yet to come or needed to find?
Oh no, the $25 million is a $75 million project, so there needs to be other funding partners. But it's a start. The federal government will probably be involved. I'm sure that the football club will come to the council. I'm sure the football club will put some in themselves. So it's a great thing for the city to see this $25 million put in by the state government. It's great.
What size of capacity will the stadium be then able to hold, and what does it mean for the Geelong community to know they've got like a big world-class stadium?
Well, the capacity of the stadium will go from about 30,000 to 35. The economic benefit for the stadium once it's at 35,000 seat capacity is about $4.1 million, and probably half of that's spent in the stadium, the other half of that's spent outside the stadium. So the economic benefit to the city is great. And it's not only that, it's going to have a 1,000 seat conference centre, or not a conference centre, I suppose it is a conference type centre, 1,000 seats. You're going to have a live site, you're going to have upgrades to the rest of the outside of it. It's going to have a museum. Noel, you got any of them old boots that you played in 1978 in the grand final down here for Newtown when you beat North Shore by 4 points kicking against a gale? It was a great day for the Newtown Football Club. Maybe we can get your boots or Huey Strawn's jumper. That could be in the museum, but who knows. But look, it's this is a great facility, not only for the Geelong Football Club, but for the community of Geelong. Last year, St Joseph's Herald Shield team played here, and the comments from the schools that came down here in one of the premier school competitions in Victoria was it was great to play on KP, it's a great community facility. We've had the motorbikes here, we've had a number of different things here. We've got an opportunity to have soccer, 2020 cricket, rugby, so there's a number of things that we'll see happening out of Skills Stadium.
This is News Geelong Friday edition, as we go to a break and return with sport and weather after this.